ग्रेविटेशन पार्ट टू यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी गॉट एन इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एंड सेंट्रिपेटल फोर्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट द यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। Earlier, we learned how Isaac Newton discovered the laws of gravity. Let's now know a bit more about him. Sir Isaac Newton was born in Woolsthorpe, near Grantham, England. He was born in a poor farming family, but he was not very good at farming. In 1661, he was sent to study at Cambridge University. In 1665, it is said that an apple fell on his head, and this encouraged Newton to connect the force that kept the moon in its orbit with the force that made the apple fall. But even before Newton's time, scientists had always been interested in the motion of planets. By the 16th century, the scientists and astronomers had managed to collect a lot of data on the motion of planets. From the data, Johannes Kepler derived three laws which govern the motion of planets, but Kepler failed to give a theory to explain why the planets moved in the way they did. It was Newton who explained that the cause of planetary motion is due to the gravitational force that the sun exerts on them. Now, can you tell why the universal law of gravitation is universal in nature? It is because the law is applicable to all the bodies in the universe. Whether the bodies are big or small, whether terrestrial or celestial, the law applies to all. Now, let us understand what exactly is the universal law of gravitation. The universal law of gravitation states that the force between two objects in the universe is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. The force is directed along the line joining the center of two objects. Mathematically, it is written as F is equal to G multiplied by M multiplied by M upon D square. Now, let's see how we can derive the mathematical representation of universal law of gravitation. Let us consider two objects A and B with masses m and m respectively, and the distance between them is d. Let the force of attraction between A and B be F. According to the universal law of gravitation, the force between the objects is directly proportional to the product of their masses. So, mathematically we can write it as F directly proportional to M multiplied by M. Now, the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two objects, that is, F directly proportional to 1 upon d square. Combining these two equations, we get F is directly proportional to M multiplied by M upon D square. Or F is equal to G multiplied by M multiplied by M upon D square, where G is equal to constant of proportionality or universal gravitation constant. So here, we can sum up the universal law of gravitation as F is equal to G multiplied by M multiplied by M upon D square. Now, let's see the mathematical formulae for universal gravitation constant G. From this equation, we can get F multiplied by D square is equal to G multiplied by M multiplied by M, or G is equal to F multiplied by D square upon M multiplied by M. Can you determine the SI unit of G from the previous equation? We can find the SI unit of G by substituting the units of mass, force and distance in this equation. The SI unit of G is Newton meter square per kilogram square. The value of universal gravitation constant G was calculated by Henry Cavendish. He used a sensitive balance to do so. The accepted value of G is equal to 6.673 multiplied by 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kilogram square. After knowing about universal law of gravitation, can you calculate the force between you and your friend sitting nearby? Let's assume both of you have a mass of 50 kilograms each and the distance between you and your friend is 1 meter. You can pause this video to do the calculation. What did you conclude? Can you feel this force? If not, why? Newton's universal law of gravitation explained some very important occurrences on Earth. It proved the existence of a force that binds all of us to the Earth. It proved how it is possible for the moon to be in motion around the Earth. And also how it is possible for the planets to revolve around the sun. It also explained the phenomenon of tides, which occur due to the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun. So, that's a physics lesson fishermen need to remember. In this video, we learned about the universal law of gravitation. In the next video, we will learn about free fall.